Steve. Good to go? Sounds like I'm all right. All right. Welcome to worship as we gather together to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Refreshed by the resurrection life we share in Christ, let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We thank you, risen Christ, for these waters where you make us new, leading us from death to life and from tears to joy. We bless you, risen Christ, that your Spirit comes to us in the grace-filled waters of rebirth, like rains to our thirsting earth, like streams to revive our souls, like cups of cool water shared with strangers. Breathe your peace into your church when we hide in fear. Clothe us with your mercy and your forgiveness. Send us companions on our journey as we share your life and make us one with the risen Christ. Cleanse our hearts, shower us with life. To you be given all praise with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Amen. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Worthy is Christ, the Lamb who was slain, whose blood set us free to be people of God. Power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and blessing and glory are His. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Sing with all the people of God and join in the hymn of all creation.
Let us pray. O God, you gave your only Son to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, and by his glorious resurrection, you delivered us from the power of death. So make us die every day to sin, that we may live with him forever in the joy of the resurrection. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Reading from the 25th chapter of Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, a rich food filled with marrow, a well-aged wine strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears of all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on this day, lo, this is our God, we have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The word of the Lord.
I need all the kids I can get. Couple here look familiar. Is that it? Happy Easter, everybody. Happy Easter to moms and dads out there. I don't know what your favorite subject is in school, but I kind of had an interest in science because you take things apart or see what makes it tick. So I have a little experiment for us today. Pack of M&Ms. Now, you would think if you cut a red M&M, it'd be red inside, right? No? You don't think it is? Let's see. Nope, it's brown. What if you cut a yellow one? It'd be yellow inside, wouldn't it? No? Let's see. Huh, it's brown. How about a green one? Gotta be green. They have green ketchup. You ever have green ketchup? No? Okay, let's see. Slipped away. Son of a gun. It's brown. You know, when you look at these M&Ms, it kind of reminds you of people. We have people, there's different size people, different color people, and we're all the same inside. We all have hearts, we're all the same inside. And Jesus loves us all. Today, he risen, and he's in heaven, and he's there for us. And there's a little song that goes, I don't know if any of you guys know it. Probably you people out there probably remember it. It's, Jesus loves his little children. You can sing along with me, everybody. All the children in the world, brown, black, and white, their children is the sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Jesus died for all the children, all the children of the world, red, brown, black, and white, and tears in the sight. Jesus loves all the children of the world. All right. Thank you all. And if you see Miss Wanda there, she might give you a pack of M&Ms. All right. And Jesus came down, and he loves everybody, no matter what size you are or what color. Jesus loves us all.
Second reading from the third chapter of Colossians. If you've been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you will also be revealed with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Gospel according to Mark, the 16th chapter. Glory to you, Lord. the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go and anoint Jesus' body. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of this tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. And as they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right-hand side. And they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, here is the place that they laid him. But rather go and tell the disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. And there you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and they fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, but they were afraid. This is the gospel of our Lord. Our gospel for this Sunday begins with an account of a group of three women headed to a tomb to finish what Pilate had started. 3 days ago, flesh was whipped, nailed, and lifted up for the world to see, and today only three headed to a tomb for a final anointing. Practical matters, I imagine, consumed them. That's what we often do at times of death. What spices should we bring? What clothes need to be brought? How will we ever roll that stone away? Jesus was dead. Final preparations needed to be made, and, well, then it was time to roll that stone back, shut up the tomb for good, and end of the Jesus story. Well, this has been a difficult year for all of us. All of us. Even at Christ Hamilton, we have lost loved ones. The ones we were used to talking with on the phone, well, they're no longer with us. We're used to sitting with them in the pews and eating with them during coffee hour, and they are no longer here. The spaces they used to occupy are now empty. We not only miss the space they used to occupy physically, but certainly the spaces that they occupied in our hearts. Those three women headed to the tomb this morning, knowing loss all too well, they no longer had their Jesus. When people go through grief, they often report about what a huge achievement it is just to put one foot in front of the other, to keep on going on. It becomes a great achievement. And perhaps that's the way it was for the Marys and the other woman who went to the tomb that first Easter. When people go through a trauma or a grief, we don't expect them to triumph, but simply to survive. Being a survivor, it is triumph enough. And as we were immersed in COVID country for over a year now, perhaps our greatest virtue was just learning to put one foot in front of the other. There are so many times in life when we need to simply keep on keeping on. In our grief and our depression, it is easy to just close ourselves off from others and from community. But we need to keep moving, to get up and get connected with others, even if we don't feel like it. And the women at the tomb, they did just that. Even though it was the last thing they ever wanted to do, heading to a tomb to complete the final preparations for their teacher, their friend, and their master. Coming out of COVID, we may feel like we need to do and connect more than ever. I encourage you to do so. You may not feel like coming to church anymore. COVID may have caused you to feel sloth-like and sluggish. But if you don't emerge from your COVID slumber, how can you ever see your shadow and know that there's only 6 more weeks of COVID winter? Now, I know that we're more than 6 weeks away, probably 6 months away, and we'll still be more than likely wearing a mask for a while. But if you don't think about doing anything else this Easter, perhaps you could make an Easter resolution. A resolution to put one foot in front of the other, to get dressed and to reconnect in person with a community of faith. See, if the Marys decided to never even leave their house, they would have missed out on the most amazing event that they ever experienced in their entire life. As they look up, they see a stone rolled away, which was very large. As they enter the tomb, they see a young man dressed in a white robe. Then they were given a message to share with the men, who more than likely weren't putting one foot in front of the other. Heck, I bet you they didn't even get out of bed. I don't know if you wholeheartedly showed up for service today. I don't know if you wholeheartedly shared in the resurrection proclamation, shared at the baptismal font that we started our service with. I said, Christ is risen, to which you said, Alleluia, he's risen indeed. Well, did you say it with a strong, firm faith and a strong belief in the reality of Christ's resurrection? Well, maybe you don't have to. Maybe all that you need to do is simply to be here, like the women were at the tomb. Perhaps you only need to keep putting one foot in front of the other, to keep on keeping on, to follow the rituals of the church, putting one foot in front of the other in that grand Easter procession. Perhaps all you need to do is to receive the body and blood of Christ and to just hold on. To hold on until you have the faith that you hope for. Thought I'd share with you a little story about Lynn. Now, Lynn told me that she had a dramatic conversion, that she had an experience in her life. She had finally found one, and a conversion experience. She said that belief had always been a problem for her, ever since she was young. She said she had greeted the faith of the church with, well, nothing but doubts and questions and misgivings. Yet here she was in midlife, being given the faith that she did not have. She said that she had a vivid experience of the presence of the risen Christ in her life. She said that it was as if a light came on in her life and things finally fell into place and she finally understood. She said, I finally saw, and Pastor, I finally believed. I asked her if she knew why she'd been given this gift of faith now at this particular time, and she said, I have no idea why. I just know that I kept standing up every Sunday and saying those words of the creed, saying them over and over again, saying them from memory, but not really believing them in my heart. If you'd stopped me one Sunday and said, well, do you really believe in what you're saying about the resurrection and the virgin birth and about all the rest? I probably would have said, well, I don't think so. But then one day I did believe. And I'm so very glad that I had stood up all over those hundreds of Sundays and I affirmed what I believed, even before I believed it. Like the women at the tomb. Just keep on keeping on. And sometime we too will all be able to proclaim, Alleluia. Don't we need that the most in our lives? Especially when things are difficult. A community-wide Easter pageant assigned various people in the town to play the different parts. The character of Jesus went to the most unlikely of people.
a big, burly, barroom brawler, an oil-filled worker, most unlikely person you would ever imagine to play Jesus. Well, after several weeks of rehearsals, the day of the Easter pageant finally arrived, and when they came to play the part where Jesus was being led away to be crucified, one little man, filling in as part of the crowd, got too caught up in the emotion of the drama. He joined in the shouts, "Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him!" as Jesus was led away toward Calvary. Then in the midst of shouting the insults at the top of his lungs, he accidentally sprayed spit all over the face of Jesus. The oil field worker stopped in his tracks. He reached up and he wiped the spit off his face. He looked at the little man and said, "Listen, buddy, I'll be back to take care of you after the resurrection." I don't know how you have come to be here this Easter morning. I don't know if you're here because you have a strong faith. Maybe you've got questions and doubts, and that's okay. I don't know why you're here, but the point is that you are. This is the day when Christ has spit in death's face. It is the day when the cross is turned into a crown, and it's the day when we can be assured by Christ that he has come back to take care of us. Death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Amen.
Alleluia.
Thank you.
We confess our faith together using the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God in all times and places in praying for the church, the world, and all who are in need. God, our peace and our strength, we pray for our nation and the world as we battle the coronavirus. Protect the most vulnerable among us, especially all who are currently sick. Give comfort to those who have lost loved ones. Grant wisdom, patience, and clarity to healthcare workers. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Where hearts are fearful and constricted, grant courage and hope. Where anxiety is widening, grant peace and reassurance. Where impossibilities close every door and window, grant imagination and purpose. Where distrusts twists our thinking, grant healing and illumination. Where spirits are daunted and weakened, grant soaring wings and strengthened dreams. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. All your creation praises you. The earth hums, the sea pulses, the stars shine, and the galaxies whirl in glorious harmonies to honor you. Let this time apart help us to reconnect with your wonderful creation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The countries of the world experience disunity and conflict. We set our minds on fear and greed rather than on your rule of justice and steadfast love. Build up all countries on your cornerstone of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We still weep with those who weep and mourn with those who mourn. Cradle the fearful, the suffering, and the dying, assuring them of your loving presence. We especially remember those who are sick. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Risen Lord, you went ahead of us into the grave and defeated the powers of evil. We remember those who have died. Inspire us to live our lives in this resurrection of hope and draw us to you in our final days. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care. And we share especially today in the power of the resurrection of your Son. To you we entrust all of these things, along in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's pray. Blessed are you, Lord our God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts. With them, we offer ourselves to your service and dedicate our lives to the care and redemption of all that you have made. For the sake of him who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in every place offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and ever-living God. But chiefly we are bound to praise you for your glorious resurrection of our Lord, for he is the true Passover Lamb who gave himself to take away our sin, who by his death has destroyed death, and by his rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and with Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and all their creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth. In mercy for our fallen world, you gave your only Son, that all those who believe in him should not perish, but have eternal life. We give thanks to you for the salvation that you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Send now your Holy Spirit into our hearts, that we may receive our Lord with a living faith as he comes to us in his Holy Supper. Amen.
Amen.
Come, Lord Jesus. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body, which I have given for you. Do this always for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup and he gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink. He said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. It has been shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this always for the remembrance of me." We share together the prayer our Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Just a note before we take communion, if you haven't been with us, please note that it's kind of a self-contained little communion cup and wafer. You'll need to peel back the top portion of it to get to the wafer, and then the next tab to get to the grape juice. Please wait until we're all ready to consume it together, and just kind of follow my instructions at that time. Please be seated.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
This is the body of Christ given for you. And this is the blood of Christ, which has been shed for you. Please stand. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and always keep you in his grace. Amen.
Almighty God, you provide the true bread from heaven, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant that we who have received the sacrament of his body and blood may abide in him and he in us, that we may be filled with the power of his endless life, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
May Almighty God send you light and truth to keep you all the days of your life. May the hand of God protect you, the holy angels accompany you, and the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen.
Amen. Before I provide the dismissal, for those of you who did not provide your offerings, please feel free if you would like before you leave the sanctuary. We have plates as you leave the door. Dismissal. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Go in peace. Share the good news. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.